Welcome back. My name is Joe Zeplin, Microsoft MVP, and this is our Power BI tutorial playlist. In this video, we're going to discuss how to make two different line charts to level up your Power BI skills. First, open up Power BI Desktop on your computer. If you don't have Power BI installed yet, no worries. Check out our first video here on how to download Power BI for free. Also, in the description below, there's a link to the sample data we'll be using in today's video. First, we're going to create a basic line chart. We're going to select two columns. One is obviously going to be date, and the second is what we're going to want to compare. Let's choose total revenue. As you can see, Power BI gives you the opportunity to choose yearly, quarterly, monthly, or daily views of your data. Currently, it's set for yearly. If you want to look at quarterly, click this X here, and now it's quarterly. Same thing for monthly and daily. One important thing to note is if your date range includes multiple years, those are going to be consolidated in the view that you choose. So if you have data from January 2022 and January 2023, your bar is going to be the total of all things January. For today's video, our data is only from 1 year, so let's go ahead and choose the monthly level. Now, this is a good start. I can see my total revenue month over month. Now I want to see what products make up that revenue. To do that, let's go to the fields column and let's select product and add it to the legend. As you can see, cookie sales are increasing each month, ice cream sales are decreasing by month, and pizza is staying relatively consistent. You can already see why a line chart is so much stronger than just a total column. For instance, if you look at total revenue, it's going to say that pizza makes up the most revenue for your company. But if you look at what's going to happen soon, your cookie sales keep increasing, where cookie's going to be your best-selling product. So this month-over-month view is very powerful. Next, if you've seen the other videos in this playlist, you know that we like to make our visuals look a lot better than this one. So go to the visualization pane, click this little paintbrush here, and we're gonna add a title, we're gonna add a border, and then we're gonna turn on data labels. See, that looks like a much more professional visual. Next, we're gonna move on to our bonus tip, visual number 2. In this one, we're gonna see if we're meeting our revenue targets by month. First, click the line and stacked column chart here. Again, we're gonna select date and set it to month, and then let's click revenue. For the third step, we have to add a goal. So in your header, click measure, and we're going to type revenue goal equals, and let's choose 2,500. Now, as you can see on the right side, revenue goal is an option. So let's click that and add it to the visual. And immediately you can see a bar chart with a goal line going across, seeing if we are hitting above the target or hanging beneath the target. Now it's time for our secret bonus tip. We're gonna go into conditional formatting. We wanna see all the months that we hit our goal in green and all the months that we didn't hit our revenue goal in red. To do this, go to the visualization pane, choose the paintbrush, scroll down to columns, and then where it says default, click this little button that says FX. At the top left, we're gonna go to format style and select rules. Then Power BI is pretty smart, so it's gonna assume that we wanna do a rule based on total revenue. Then make sure summarization is set to sum. And then we're gonna set our rules for our two colors. So we wanna show red if it's less than 2,500. So we're gonna say if value is greater than or equal to 0 and less than 2,500, then, and let's select a red. Then we're gonna select a new rule and say if value is greater than or equal to 2,500, our goal, and less than, and for this one, I like to choose a really high number, so let's just put a bunch of 9s. And for color, let's select a green and press OK. And immediately, you can see that we hit our goal in 9 of 12 months, and the months that we didn't were February, March, and September. And as always, we're gonna go to our secret bonus tips, go to the visualization pane, turn on title, add a border, and data labels. And great, great job. You now know how to effectively use line charts in Power BI. In our next video, we're going to move on to pie charts. Of all the visuals, pie charts are probably the most controversial topic. There's times to use them, times to not use them, a lot of do's and don'ts. I want to make sure that we're using the best practices together. So make sure you click this video on how to use pie charts effectively. Also, as a friendly reminder, I do go live fairly often to answer your Power BI questions. So make sure you hit that bell there. When I go live, you'll get a notification that I'm online. Let me help you. Great job today. Welcome to the Startup Squad. And as always, start small, start today. I'll see you in the next video.